Okay, we're in the VOD. Quick, speed run, you're funny. Okay, that's sufficient enough. Okay, now we're streaming. Excellent, wonderful. Just put some fucking shit on. Do you think that they made video games?
Oh, that'd be fucked up. I don't think they do that.
I don't. They could never. All right. I need to make the blue sky post. Because you can't schedule posts on here right now.
This is so sad. Oh, bitch!
Ow! Me.
How's it going?
Biting you!
Holy moly.
So, we have something really exciting lined up for the last stream of 2023. Can you guess what it is?
What is it?
We're just playing more Final Fantasy VII.
That's fair.
That's it, fucking fantasy!
Woo!
Yeah!
That's what I've been waiting for, baby!
Yeah, baby! That's what we've been waiting for!
Wahoo!
Okay.
I'll crack open my last aha for the year.
Let's go! Grip it and rip it! do I have another funny to put in place of he was forced to eat material when he was 7? I'm just like cycling through like funny fantasy images that I have for these, and you know what? That's just how we do it. Know that this game was developed by Squaresoft?
Do either of you have Lethal Company, by the way?
I do!
Oh, I don't.
Heck. Well, Ginge, we should stream Lethal Company sometime.
Yes! I have not played it, actually. Like, I have been sitting on it. And I've never booted it up.
It's so fucking
and it's not for lack of interest. I am very interested in playing this game.
You've been pretty busy, right?
Yeah. Oh, here we go. This is a good one. This is a wonderful image that I'm gonna have the fucking. All right, I need to post my post for y'all to shill.
Yeah. I need to get the fucking audio of Eggman from Sonic Adventure 2 Battles, like, yosh, onto my soundboard. Tweetara?
Actually, it's X now?
Nobody calls that shit X!
Nobody calls it X!
Nobody calls that shit X.
Nobody does. I don't know anybody who does. I think that's hilarious. Right, I need to do this thing. Video gaming.
Excuse me.
So I completely forgot where we oh right. We just did coping snowboard. and got hypothermia. As you do. Okay, everybody's okay. Everybody's fine. What was I gonna say? I was going to say something and I completely lost it.
No.
Can we give it up for DoorDash drivers though for making the most questionable decisions of logic I've ever seen?
Oh my god.
Every single time I order like ice cream or a milkshake or something, they're like, oh, I'm gonna take three other orders and deliver those first.
Yeah. I get that it's like they're trying to like, you know,
Maximize profit
and also like, you know, time spent.
Uh-huh.
But like, it's also just like, I just want my milkshake.
You have ice cream.
It is cold and it's gonna melt. My first experience with DoorDash was my last because it was terrible.
Yeah, like, I've had, you know, DoorDash is like very iffy for me. Of like, some days I order it because I'm lazy and it gets here at a reasonable time and I get all my stuff and it's fine. Other times I order, you know, a milkshake with my cheeseburger and it gets here like literally an hour later. And I'm like, y'all, you cannot be doing that. Okay. So, there is a thing that I absolutely need to do here. Is that my fucking... Is that Speak of the Devil? Is that my... No, it's my mom. Did I have a nice Christmas?
Well, did you?
I don't know, it was okay.
Okay.
I had a very Christmas.
You had a very Christmas.
I had a very Christmas. Oh! Oh, we lost Al. I didn't realize.
No.
Oh my god, I am not paying attention. White boy got fucked up.
White boy got fucked up by the rabbits. By the rabbit.
The rabbits.
The rabbits.
Yippee, we did it. Okay, so there's a thing that I need to do here. And I legit do not remember how to fucking do it. Thank you. Ah, scary.
Oops, spooky. The monster appeared.
The monster appeared. Run. We don't seem to be doing much here.
The same dirty hands that touched the- Oh my god!
I'll never forgive you! Okay, this is exactly what we needed to do.
I didn't have the sound. Oh yeah, okay, that was the right song.
Yeah.
I didn't have the sound on. Oops.
Oops. Oh my god. Goofy sure can landscape. Oh no, not Ice 2. The sequel to Ice.
Next thing you know, they'll invent Ice 3.
Oh god. Scary. Oh, please leave him alone. Please leave him alone. Oh my god. Oh! Okay.
That was a pretty short boss fight, actually.
Yippee!
Yahoo!
Ah-hoo! Yippee! Hurry!
Buy this!
I want to point out that I was, like, when I got to this point of the game, I was, like, 10 levels higher than you.
Yeah, well, I'm stupid.
And I just think that's funny. Oh, else Wi-Fi crashed.
Oh no!
This is so sad.
Everybody in chat, please pray for them. Anyway, we can do one of the most crack things you could ever possibly do in this game now.
Right, because you're gonna element Alexander, aren't you?
Fuck yes, I am. Cloud is doing holy damage now.
I cast Holy Sword, fuck you!
Buster has become Catholic.
Oh my god.
I had lightning on him, didn't I? Yeah. Okay, well, there we go. You may brag that you were 10 levels above me, and you are honestly probably right to do so. But you saw how piss easy that boss fight was.
Yeah, true.
And that's how you get Alexander. Yippee. Listen, it's okay. I'm sure chat would forgive me if I need to cheat again. They wouldn't forgive me, chat.
Ah, shoot, I'm boo-boo!
What'd you do?
I made myself a smoothie today, but I didn't put, like, half of the stuff I said I was gonna try in it.
Oh, you are boo-boo.
Yeah.
Hang on, let me... out of sheer curiosity, I wanna see what level is recommended to be. Like, bare minimum.
I was gonna say, I did also overlevel, like, a lot, before the end of, this one. Because I was really, really excited to see Red's, last limit break.
Ah, yeah. Get an answer?
Uh-huh.
None of these are giving me what I need.
I'm gonna say poof. I'm gonna sound like such a fucking weirdo for what I'm about to say, but I made myself my smoothie today, and I was going to try and put some asparagus and spinach in it, because it doesn't really affect the flavor too terribly, but it's really, really good for you.
I mean, okay. I probably heard
weirder. I forgot to. Yeah.
Oh no, not the Transformers! Here I go dying again. No, we're just... Okay, it says at Genova Life on this guide here,
uh-huh.
a good level to be at would be like 32.
Huh.
Okay, so I'm not doing
so you're not
terrible
right now.
But I could be doing better.
You could be.
One second, my food is here. I'm just gonna let Cloud die of hypothermia again.
This is so sad.
I probably should, like, heal them, though, so I don't accidentally fucking game over.
I was about to say, why don't you pause first?
Yeah.
Why don't you just stay on the pause menu?
One sec. Thank you. chat.
Oh, chat.
I think I got bad news.
What's the bad news?
Not only did they take their precious time with ice cream, so it's probably all kind of sloppy now. But I think they screwed up my order.
No!
I think I ordered a 10-piece nuggie, and there's eight in here. So, my ass about to complain. I gotta put this somewhere for now, though. I cannot have a Lego Indiana Jones set on my desk. That was something. That was probably a knife. I'll worry about it later. Anyway, how are you doing, Ghosty? How are you doing this fine December 29th, 2023?
Oh... I'm chilling.
When aren't you, though? Let's be real here.
True.
When you're bawling for fucking whole game. But
when I'm bawling for whole game. I keep thinking about whole game.
Oh, it's been on my mind all day.
Do you understand? I know you understand, because you did this knowing.
Out of character. They knew, chat. In character, they don't know, chat.
Hi, Doze.
Hi.
Welcome back.
My Wi-Fi crashed.
It's okay, you didn't miss a whole lot.
Okay.
We were just talking about whole game.
Oh.
Well,
and how...
Before we go into that, I just want to point out the terrifying boss battle we got in. And got Alexander. It ended in three turns.
The very short boss fight.
Why was Emile's head on the floor? Oh, that's too dark. I don't have time to deal with that right now. I need to plug in my index controller. But anyway, whole game.
Whole game.
So we had a really funny session last night. And I do mean funny before any other emotion present. I got to introduce the party to my little scrundlies, the Partitia brothers.
Hell yeah. How'd that go?
So... how much do you know about my funny little kobold brothers, Doze?
I know one of them is vile and sexual.
one of them is, violent sexual, pretty blatantly and, what's the word I'm looking for? Like, unashamedly, Xenos-inspired as a guy.
Oh,
I like him.
Oh, good.
He's my favorite flavor of guy. The other one is his kind of an asshole younger brother, who's a guy I played in a tabletop, like, last year.
Yeah.
About to be 2 years ago. Jesus Christ. Time's fake. They're both pretty central characters to the whole game experience in general. We opened basically with the older one barely missing a spear thrown directly at Aster's face. He should have gotten out of the way, though, honestly.
I rolled a one, there. Okay? If I was cool,
yeah.
I would have, but the dice said no.
True. And then the younger one called him, like, a slur twice in Draconic.
Oh my god.
And, and pointed at him and laughed and said, "Wow, you really think you're hot shit, huh? You fucking idiot." Aster didn't take this very well.
Not at all.
And had almost what I would maybe even call a little bit of a white boy moment.
I wouldn't even say almost. I would say he just did.
Hello, Charles.
Hello, Charles.
Hello. Hey, white boy moment?
We're talking about the whole game.
Oh.
He had a little bit of a white boy moment. Fired a warning shot at one of them to, you know, try and prove some amount of bravado, and that was not the correct play.
That was a no-no.
That was the wrong decision.
Oh no.
So, from what I've gathered, is that we have two white boys. We have three white boys on the field now.
What are the other two?
Cadella and Reese.
They kind of are.
We have, a pair of entitled children and also entitled child, and I think all three of them have problems.
Yeah, but all three of them have problems on purpose.
Mm-hmm. I'm just going to say, Ghosty, you need to be really fucking careful of being mean to Aster right now, because it's early enough in the game to where this campaign could just be a whole ass Jokerification arc, and I don't know if any of us want that.
Oh,
but it'd be so funny.
It would be funny, I will not deny, but do we really want to deal with Jokerification before we're even, like, done with the first dungeon?
It's okay, I have ways to reel him back in. However, just to continue, firing a warning shot at a dude is perhaps not a very good idea when his incredibly combat sexual brother is like 3 feet away and may have not taken that threat particularly well. So Azra has basically I don't want to say like initiated, but a little bit initiated a fight with a guy who is a fair bit stronger than him.
Oh man.
Ghosty, you know how I play RPGs. I can beat him.
I'm gonna tell you up front, no the fuck you can't.
You are not him.
You are not him.
Binge over here like, nah, I'd win.
I'd win, somehow, through sheer determination and brute force. How do you think I beat Final Fantasy VII the first time?
There's a big ol' eventually that's hiding somewhere.
Yo, is that another ribbon? Let's fucking go.
They don't know, chat. The combat I'm about to throw them in was balanced for the whole party and not two people.
Oh.
And the only reason why Riz up's there is because multiple reasons, but it's not because his own ego is being damaged here.
Riz up just wants to be a good little boy.
Yeah.
See, like, I am seeing this go so many ways for Aster and the rest of the party of, like, yeah, he's a self-centered asshole right now, but, like, something is going to change, and, like, he's gonna make a fucking sacrifice that's gonna prove everybody wrong or some shit.
While on Rizap's eyes, all Aster needs to do is just chill the fuck out.
I hope you guys are having fun with the whole game.
Oh, we are.
Good.
What?
I just got $8 on DoorDash.
Oh.
Nice. Because they fucked up your
because
order?
Because they fucked up my order. I'm gonna be real.
They gave you melted ice cream?
They probably did. I haven't actually touched that yet. No, Whoa. They gave me, I ordered a 10-piece nugget, and they gave me 8.
Oh!
I'm not, like, I don't want to, like, be a fucking Karen or anything. But I make an exception with DoorDash because Dashers are fucking crazy sometimes, and also, DoorDash is fucking expensive. You bet your ass I'm gonna do anything for credit.
I've had better luck with Uber Eats so far.
Uber Eats does not deliver to my house for some reason.
Oh, that's weird.
Oh yeah, because you're not in San Antonio proper where there's enough Tesla chargers for their cars.
No.
I don't actually know the reason.
No, I think it's because our address is newer, technically. Like, our house was only built, 3 years ago now?
I don't know.
I don't fucking know. I just know they don't deliver to my house.
Be right back. Roommates are talking to me.
Okay. Aw. I'm just saying, Ghosty, be fucking careful. Do not jokerfy my boy right now.
And I'm just saying, if your boy didn't want to get jokerfied, he shouldn't have shot a bullet at, like, maybe actually unironically two of the richest people on this island.
Okay, but he doesn't fucking know that.
He doesn't know that.
But this is also the same people who threw a fucking polearm at a deer that would have killed you otherwise. Saving
Correct.
Your life.
Cadell did that. He was shooting at Reese.
Yeah, but...
Who is nothing but a racist snob.
I don't believe he said anything racist in any of those remarks.
Okay, but I think he's racist.
I assure you he is not.
He might be a little racist.
I don't write racist characters.
He's bigoted, but not racist. You can be a bigot and not be racist. You just have other stereotypes to focus on instead.
He, in his current state, is not a good person for a number of reasons, but racism is not one of them. He will get better.
This whole campaign is just therapy sword.
In some ways more than others, too.
I'm gonna be extremely upfront. Everyone in that fucking field right now is going to get therapy sorted one way or another.
Even Lily? She seems normal.
She is going to get therapy sorted one way or another.
We're going to witness the event that enables her to need therapy.
Yeah.
If not be the catalyst for it.
Well, now...
Listen. I think if anybody had to put up with Darrow, they would also need therapy.
Mm-hmm.
And Rizap needed therapy out the gate. Oh, sorry.
I think Darrow also needs therapy for himself.
The whole game arts are literally just going to be passing around the therapy sword between the party and the closest NPC. The guy who needs it most at the moment.
So when you say therapy sorted, do you mean using the therapy sword or being hit by the therapy sword?
Both.
I mean, I kept that ambiguous for a reason, Charles.
Oh. Oh, that's gonna be fun.
Having what?
Hot dogs.
Yo.
What kind of hot dogs?
Just hot dogs.
I'll take that hot dog with extra sauce, please.
I'll I'll take the hot dog.
Let's put a shipment of mustard on mine.
Which of your friends is a hot dog?
I date one of those.
Say Rev 13 is a hot dog, I mean, like, he's literally on fire. True.
Good. Oh my god, Miku. She's screaming.
Oh, we love screaming cats in this house. Mostly because we have one.
Screaming cats. Speaking of pets, I have some very important pictures to share in the Discord chat. Give me a moment.
While you get those together, I need to post a guy. This guy's gonna beat your ass. And he's going to feel good about it.
There he is!
There he is!
Dog glow.
Is he going to get better? Is Cadell going to get better?
Yeah, he's also gonna get better.
I don't know what better for him looks like, honestly.
Taking a fucking chill pill.
I was gonna say, like, combat is like his whole deal. If he loses that, what does he have?
An Adderall prescription?
Yeah, these Wendy's fries kind of fucking suck.
Yeah, man.
Oh, that dog though. The dog looks like it has the eyes of a kitten.
Her name is Pixie.
This is the stupid one you were posting earlier.
With the dumb eyes, yeah.
Yeah, I love her.
Yeah, she looks like she has the eyes of a kitten. Blue and quickly a brain behind them.
Yeah.
But I mean that in a positive way. It's endearing and cute. But it also sounds like she could be getting up to mischief.
Thankfully she doesn't get up to mischief much so far.
I have to restrain myself, I'm realizing now, from doing the I could fix it, but it'd be so much funnier to see what the fuck I can make it worse on to Aster. Because to be fair, it would be.
You guys wanna see the guy?
The guy?
The guy. Waken the beast to sleeping.
God.
Time in the ether keepers.
There he is!
It's him! It's
Alexander!
Alexander!
I love him!
He's gonna rise up with my thunder.
Hello, Pyro! Welcome to the final stream of 2023. We have something really exciting. We're just playing Final Fantasy, that's it. We're gonna be back next week like nothing ever happened.
It's me, I'm Alexander.
I'm excited. You go forward and back right into the system. Forward and back.
Sorry. I'm rotating Aster in my mind as well because I'm trying to figure out how to fit him after I beat his ass.
Will you? Will you really fix him?
I might need to at least a little bit. I need to put some duct tape on him so he doesn't just leave the fucking party.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to say last night, of how are you going to fix this? Like, to ensure that he doesn't fucking just bail.
Well, first of all, I'm going to remind him that that's a problem of his own fucking making.
And you're right to do so. It was his fault.
He is going to narc the fuck out this entire interaction to Eileen, and she's going to be like, nope, that was your fault. You shouldn't have done that. That is a waste of resource, energy, time, money, and your own physical health, you fucking... You little guy. You little fella.
See, okay. The thing is I think, you know, he does realize that it was his fault. But he's more so mad about the party, like, abandoning him when he was toted to be the leader. And
when that whole
thing is like, how am I supposed to be a leader if all these fucking kindergartners don't fucking listen to me?
Well, first step is to actually act like one.
I know this. He doesn't.
Yeah, Aster does not fucking know.
Aster is going
he
to
does
have
not
to learn.
Know chat.
Aster's going to have to learn the
he's
hard
going
way
to
that
have
he has
to.
Learn.
That's
well,
the
look at the rest of his party as peers and not as people to boss around. Or a little.
What do you think of it?
No, go ahead.
I just realized something. If, for whatever reason, Rizap just gives up on Aster, he can just leave at any time, because Cadell technically doesn't really have any quarrel with Rizap here. He'd probably get upset that he's being a coward here, but the quarrel is not originally with him.
I was about to say, dead ass, Cadell's looking at him like, you're fucking stupid, but I respect the balls, man, go for it. Fuck, give it a shot, buddy.
I need a good excuse to get rid of this shield, to be honest. It's hardly even worth selling.
Damn.
Like, I cannot overstate just how crappy this shield is. The only reason why you would ever have a wooden shield is if you found a pot lid, or it is literally the only shield you can afford. In my case, it was the latter.
Mm-hmm.
Because I saw that shield block action and I thought, maybe I should be using that. Since there's no other tank. So, yeah, I'm basically just walking in like Link with a pot lid and a wooden stick. I guess fucking Ganondorf over here. Oh, and Astra's there too, I guess.
I'm gonna say pretty explicitly, the other two NPCs would have been in the room also maybe would have helped if Astra didn't in a fit of rage, say, don't talk to me about them like they're my friend either, and they just don't want to get involved now.
Oh no!
Well, they don't matter. They're not part of the party.
Wow!
To Aster. I enjoy them. But they don't matter.
They have their own insights that are being about the situation that are being completely ignored because this fucking bird.
Yeah.
This is the first step of Aster's character arc, and I enjoy it.
I want that man to learn.
He gonna learn what today, boy. Oh my fucking god.
Oh,
I'm gonna learn
today,
stop
boy.
Dying. So many Phoenix Downs. Get
Please
up, white down. Boy.
Quick, it's up again. We're never gonna keep it down.
He's gonna fall down a lot, actually. He's evil. He just needs a nap. Let's face it, he does need a nap.
he does. He's been through a lot.
Oh no, I found something terrible.
For who?
A principal Peter Griffin medallion. Oh, God.
Mega Elixir.
Wait, I forget. Am I allowed to post links in here?
Yeah.
No.
Oh, shoot. Well, I'll send the link to Pyro 2.
No links.
So that way...
No Zeldas.
I'm going to go ahead and send the link directly to Pyro 2, so that way Pyro can also peep the horrors.
Okay, then do it.
Fine, I just did. Yes.
Did you guys go trick-or-treating for Christmas?
Did you guys go trick-or-treating?
Man, I don't think we even got candy to hand out this year because it was dead like last year, but I wouldn't know because I was at work.
Damn.
On Halloween, it was really sad.
According that to sucks. My stepmom, there was like a total of maybe like 3 trick-or-treaters.
Damn.
Apparently there's a thing that like, a lot of parents opt to go to, like, parking lots and do this thing called trunk-or-treating instead now?
Oh, yeah.
Like... Sure, I guess?
I think it's because it's supposedly safer.
How?
I don't know.
Modern Halloween confuses me.
Congratulations, we're getting old at the ripe old age of 24, 25.
I'm too young to feel this old, let's be real here.
Technology and culture are moving so fast.
Be right back, dinner's ready.
Okay.
Toxic barf. I think I got him with confusion.
Ooh, nice.
Speed source. Now I can go fast. Okay. Wait, no, I want to save first.
Back when I was in Simi Valley, I remember there was this, like, super duper decorated house that was like so well decorated to the point where you would go through this little tunnel, sort of like a haunted house almost. And as far as I'm aware, it was either inside the garage or inside the house itself. And that was part of the whole experience. They like rotate between 2 or 3 different themes every year. Potential contacts, Mike and his pals, good and fentanyls. God.
What
still get is.
Fuck.
All this woke candy.
What really gets me is like that whole thing about. Oh, they're putting drugs in kids' candy! They're giving kids weed!
No, they're like, not. Weed's expensive.
Yeah!
For real.
Why would you give away the good shit?
Back when I'm lunching.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
I feel like I really need to give credit, because, again, you're gonna find this insanely hilarious, Al. So Daniel's playing a bard. And this little fucking Neglet is maybe the most chaotic bard I've ever seen in my life. So much so that because Daniel has experience just, you know, making music, we will be in the middle of an in-character argument, and his character will put in the channel Buddy Holly riff on the instrument he's playing.
Here's an example of one such time.
I saw this great shot that Bing posted. You made me laugh.
Which screenshot was that?
Shut your mouth for once in your goddamn miserable life, followed by Buddy Holly riff.
Oh yeah.
Counterattack. Level up. Great, now we can die faster.
I'm gonna be real, it's gonna take a concerted effort to make sure a bleed doesn't happen. Because I put way too much of myself into Rizap. I'm only noticing now just how relatable he is, and oof.
It's okay. It's okay to put a bit of a guy into yourself. And maybe even a lot of a guy. You know, I, again, think it's fine, and I don't think it's been a problem at all.
Well, it's a problem for me, because whenever Rizab gets insulted, my subconscious is like, oh, you know, this could apply to you too, just fine.
The problem is that it doesn't, because your character is in extreme circumstances, and you are not.
Yeah. And I have to keep reminding myself of that.
Your character is inside the fucking hole.
Yeah, my character is in, like, worst possible circumstances other than jail. Actually, hell, jail would actually be
objectively better. I was about to say,
jail
might be a bit better for you right now, actually.
Yeah.
My brother in tables, you jumped in the hole.
I keep forgetting to post, like, all the funnies that I've drawn on my Twitter. Ghosty, post my most recent one in chat for Owl.
What's that do?
I'm busy finaling my fantasy till she's 7.
Till she's 7.
She finaled my fantasy till I 7.
It is a related post.
Oh yeah, and there's also this.
I saw that one too, that one's good.
Which one was it?
Cadell in the corner.
Oh yeah. Yeah! Oh! Oh!
Shoutouts to this one as well.
You said it in any way, curious.
Oh, that's a guy!
I am very intelligent.
Oh shit, that is a guy.
I didn't look that closely, and I thought the head on the right, with the horns, was actually wearing a bowler hat. See what I mean, right?
Yeah.
Like, at a certain angle, it kind of looks like a hat.
I keep not doing it because she's not the focus at this exact moment, but I want to Eileen post more. She's, like, probably my second favorite NPC I've made for whole game.
It would be so funny if we, like, found out a way to make some sort of magic communicator shit or something. Just to provide an excuse for Eileen to shit-talk us. Like, if we're gonna have a CEO, to have an outlet for her to be just as sassy as you.
Kind of just throwing this fucking fire.
I hate to put analogies to other video games, especially maybe even cringe ones in my mind, but what's jumping to my mind is the thought of, like, treating Eileen like
the token navigator character of any given Persona game, and she's just telling you enemy weaknesses or whatever, and you have to be like, yeah, I fucking know. Yeah, it's a thing made of ice. Of course it's weak to fire. Duh. Laster. Looking cool, Laster.
Kill you. I'll have to kill you if you pull that out on me.
Wow, looking cool, Laster. I can't do that too, but it'd be so funny.
Small hot dogs, then. Are they like ballpark size? Do you have like breakfast or lunch? If you answer no to either of those, then we should probably get another hot dog.
I can't have another hot dog.
Oh.
But I could probably grab something.
I wasted a Phoenix down on Yuffie. I'm throwing this fucking fight. Unless this kills
him. Oh no.
Oh, it's so true.
Fool that you are.
Is this our new demon wall?
No. This one's not that bad. I'm making mistakes here. Demon Wall's just fucking mean.
Also, I love how the film reel has the Squaresoft logo on it.
I like how the game has the Squaresoft logo on it. I'm not even gonna bother with these fries anymore. I'm not gonna pretend to myself that these are okay.
There are just some places out there that give you fries that honestly just feel like filler more than anything.
Yeah, but Wendy's fries are pretty alright most of the time.
Yeah. Del Taco fries, though. Oh my god, those ones suck.
Why would you get fries from a taco place?
Well, for one, the taco place was previously just a taco place, but also there was another chain, a burger chain, that combined with them, and they kept the burger thing for some reason. Del Taco has burgers. And as a result, they also have fries. And it's kind of stuck. For a very bad reason. Big fries suck.
It sucks.
And they like keep taking these fries, and they have to use the fries in everything they can. And that includes like putting fries into burritos.
That sounds nasty.
It is terrible! Pyro, I'm going to save the trouble. You cannot have these fries. They are not good fries. Unless you're talking about Jimmy's fries, then you're gonna have to ask.
You're just gonna be disappointed. Like, these are like,
it's going to make you feel bad for being hungry. There's just some food that makes you wish.
White boy, stop dying! Oh my god!
Me when the white boy.
No, I'm just gonna fucking.
Dies before the white wind.
I'm gonna fucking restart this shit because I'm sick of white boy dying constantly.
Oh my god.
Gonna go ahead and play this game like how the old greats used to. That's right, we're gonna cheat.
That's right, we're gonna cheat.
I'm not cheating. I'm restarting. There's a difference.
No, I know, but I keep thinking about the edit of the AVGN being like Billy, trying to do it like the legends Billy Mitchell do.
Yeah, that's right. We're gonna cheat. Yeah, no, that's funny. Okay. Counterattack, gotta go. Instead, we get
still can't get over the fucking Peter Medallion.
That's where your mind's gonna be tonight.
What?
The Peter Medallion. Can't get over it. That's where you're gonna be tonight.
I haven't taken a gummy at all, and this is still not making any sense to me.
You're gonna focus on it, is what I'm saying.
Nah.
This funny guy. So silly. I don't know what keeps healing red, but it's funny.
Probably an immunity to something.
See, you're already doing better now that Cloud's not fucking dead. White boy right away. I'm also remembering that there is one fatal mistake that I seem to have like completely forgotten about until just now. I don't have a barrier materia.
Oh, you're boo boo.
I am boo boo. I did. That's like I was doing that. My first run! How could I have forgotten? I'm
You're
so silly!
A fool!
That's like... I'm having this flashback to that one time that we were using the wrong barrier for one of those boss fights in the remake.
No, it was Crisis Core.
It was Crisis Core.
You were using, like...
I was using two barriers instead of barrier and M-barrier.
Yeah. It's just like, that's not how that works. Man.
Okay, well, either way, it's so Jover anyway. So, it's fine. We're fine. We're winning. Yuffie's about to end this whole man's career. Or not, that's gonna kill her. Nope, it's okay. Nope. Oh damn, that was not a bad run actually. So the problem is the fucking cover materia. I need to get that off Cloud. He's not beefy enough for it. He's just a little twink. How about you behave yourself? Oh no, never mind.
The Ganesh.
Old men all the time.
True.
A headshot?
Yeah, that was the whole thing.
Yeah. Oh wait, you're playing in space too. You got gassed by Ori.
I got gassed by people other than Ori, but yeah.
And Ori.
Wasn't Pyro one of those people?
Pyro may have assisted in some way or another.
Ghosty, you're so predictable. How come other people can gaslight you but I can't?
I don't know.
That's fucked up.
Gotta play to my needs a bit better.
Because Kosti, that lamp on the wall just turned on by itself.
Oh my god!
I don't know if you can gaslight me into anything. That's a pretty bold claim. No one's been able to gaslight me into literally anything.
Oh, and the lamp just extinguished on its own, too.
Huh? Hey, Charles.
What?
The creature's nearby.
What creature?
The creature.
Is it the creature that lives in the basement that we've...
No, you live in California, they don't have those. The creature.
That's right, we don't! We also don't have attics!
True.
Or at the very least, easily accessible ones. Because... Well, for one, the roof is flat as fuck. We don't get any snow whatsoever, so there's no point.
Oh, don't sit around and want out now, you ding-dong. You asked to be in here. You were gonna beg until you got in, and now you're gonna cry until I let you out.
Doggy sweep, let's go.
Oh wait, I think I just win now.
But...
Oh shit, yeah!
Cause this is the head that only does the attack that heals me. That heals Red in particular. I think I just won.
Lamel.
Yep,
Ace.
Oh gaming! Oh gaming! Oh, we're gonna crank that shit up to times 5. Gaming.
Now it's just a war of attrition. Where your resources just do not run out.
We did it, Goggy Sweep.
Do you have something you want to say? Do you have something you want to say?
Oh, you're grumpy. You're a grumpy baby.
Mwah. Get out of here.
That's it. That's gaming, baby.
Ellie sounds so much louder on mic.
Yeah, because I hold her up to it. Are you kidding me?
Wow.
Chat?
Oh my fucking god.
Oh my god!
Why does this keep happening to you?
That wasn't even my
You didn't get a chance to do anything!
Oh my god. He is beating your ass in the QRTs.
Oh wait, no, I can put counterattack on.
I am so sorry that's happening to you, Ginge. Wait, is it the same guy again?
I have to beat this guy again.
Oh yeah.
I know what I'm doing this time. I have to kill that head first. That way, if everybody dies, here's how Red can still win this. We'll be right back.
can't wait for next Saturday. My players are going to be dealing with a six-legged giant chameleon that does not want to be a six-legged giant chameleon. He wants to be a normal-sized six-legged giant chameleon. No, not giant. Probably not giant chameleon. Just a normal-sized six-legged
chameleon. There are words falling out of your mouth.
Yeah.
I just thought you were wrong.
Yeah, I know. Guy who like owns this chameleon doesn't seem to be all that alarmed, and instead he's like going to grab his stuff and letting the rest of the party deal with it. It's gonna be so stupid. Can't wait. Reminds me, I should probably ping them and let them know that we're playing this one. Unless something comes up.
Yuffie's about to die. Oh, Clouds. Yep, we won. It's over.
Hell yeah.
Oh my god, you did it.
I did it again. It's okay. That's the only attack I have to watch out for. It's the one where he does the rock.
It's the rocks from the training mission all over again.
He's like, oh, let me hurt you. I'm sorry.
Yippee! Yahoo!
Okay. I'm gonna cheat, but in a lesser way. I'm gonna turn the random encounters off so I can go back and save. So I don't get stuck in a surprise boss fight. With only red. Okay, we're living. See, I think Lethal Company stream is a fun idea, but I'm also still very entertained by the idea of Stranger in Paradise stream.
Well, I only got one of those games.
I don't know if Stranger in Paradise would, like, work for you simply because that game is so fucking unoptimized.
Yeah, my potato computer probably couldn't handle it.
I was having trouble on, like, my computer last time we played it. And it's not that it's, like, a graphically intensive game. It's just unoptimized to hell.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like, one of the most popular mods to make the game run faster
makes
is literally
everybody
just
bald.
Making everyone bald.
Yo, pre-render cutscene. Oh, what is this? Uh-oh.
Aurora Borealis?
Aurora Borealis. I like it when you can move around in these cutscenes.
Yeah.
It's really funny.
It's like, get your spiky-ass hair out of the way of the camera.
Get your spiky-ass hair out of the cutscene! Anyway, we're at the Northern Crater, everybody. Why did he do that little spin? An old crater. Something fell out of the sky and crashed down here, leaving a scar on the planet.
Maybe it was a meteor.
It's slowly healing its old wound. Sephiroth took that energy and is trying to use the meteor. Next time, the wound won't be so small.
This is so sad.
Ah, time for a random encounter! It's a bomb!
That's not for bomb.
Bomb blast! Oh, ouchie.
Cloud is dead.
That hurts a little.
I love how only Cloud got fucked up by that. Back to Seppi Roth.
Cloud, wait for me! Hello, Tifa. Please, take me with you. You're going after Sephiroth, aren't you? I've lost a lot because of Sephiroth, too. So please take me along. Don't say no, okay? Okay. Let's go! Let's take Yuffie. Red is there. Oh no! Oh no!
Red has all the materia.
No! Tifa has fucking nothing! Oh no!
Wait, who was it that brought up the Lethal Company stream? Oh! Oh yeah, we should absolutely do that sometime.
Yeah.
And we can have, like, way more than four people if we want.
True.
That would be a lot of fun, to be honest.
Gigi hasn't played it yet. We should do an unmodded stream first.
Yeah. And Ginge absolutely has to go in blind.
As blind as possible, at least.
Yeah.
That guy just died.
Ugh.
What's this? Received Neo Bahamut. They made another Bahamut.
Oh yeah, as a heads up, Ginge, because of the way the game works, we probably
I
want
don't,
to be in a Discord call.
I know.
Okay.
I'm not making any commitments right now.
Okay.
Cloud, can you please go to the save point? Thank you. That wasn't so hard, was it? That's... It's the Shinra! So I finally found you. I love these guys. They're so stupid.
I was about to say, for me, part of the super rich company, these guys are fucking idiots. Looking at the guy laughing, like, in the corner maniacally. Yeah, we want him. I mean, he can continue to work at our company.
Say what you will about Hojo, he gets results. Like, results for what?
Results? Which he gets.
Some kind of result or another. He got so bad. Oh my god, it's the thing.
Okay, I think despite being underleveled and under-equipped... Oh, okay. Maybe we might not be so bad. I think this is mostly a story instance anyway.
It keeps hitting you with it.
I think this is the point in the game where, it starts getting really funny, actually. Saw the guy. Oh no, he fell off. Oh, it's the cube.
The cube.
Two goblins and a
sculpture.
Hey, those look like some cubes over there. Ah, sweet cube. Ah, sweet cube.
Sweet cube.
I also just remembered Red had white wind on him, but you know what? It's okay. It's fine.
That would be.
Cloud has gear two. I'll pair with all. We'll be okay.
We're making it to the golden crater with this one.
What's gonna happen to Aster?
We're gonna get to the point of the campaign where there's gonna play something and the entire party's like, yeah, we are gonna make it out of the hole with this one. I still think it's insanely hilarious that Taylor has gone with this character gimmick. Because it is, like, so purposely intrusive to the vibes of the campaign that I had to decide to make that like something of narrative importance. You've just got a normal fucking, like, RPG happening around you, and then you've got this little fucking guy playing Buddy Holly in the background.
Oh, the Kaiser Knuckle. Has hella materia slots, but her attack is still better. And she's not even using materia right now anyway, it's fine.
Yeah.
I will slap some summons on her though, just because.
I should probably make myself some dinner. What is.
What
oh,
is
I think
for
I know
dinner?
What's on. I think I know what's for dinner.
Chili fries.
Oh yeah, chili fries!
But like, I get to make them myself. Because I have chili, I have fries, I have green onion, I have sour cream. What more do you need for chili fries? We are at about an hour and a half, I think.
Okay, well... I've got people inviting me places tonight, so I'll probably wrap up here in the next 30 minutes. That'll be a 2-hour stream. That's pretty good.
Yeah. Solid amount of time. And you've made some good progress.
We're at the point of the game where progress feels like it, like, it's not substantial, but it's a lot. Of just the way the game is structured. it's kind of weird to think that Final Fantasy VII is, like, on the shorter side.
Yeah.
This little guy. It's just fucking... Because, like, you hear JRPG, and, like, you know, you're expecting, like, oh, 90 to 100 hours. But, like, Final Fantasy VII, for just the, like, main plot, is, like, a 50-hour RPG.
It's so funny to me, because I'm gonna be the RPG guy for a second.
Okay.
Threatening. A lot of RPGs have, like, a reputation for being 80 to 90 hour long games, and I'm going to insist that that's only if you're, like, literally trying to get everything done for the vast majority of them. If you're just trying to play through the RPG, most of them are only 40 to 50 hours.
Isn't Xenoblade about 70? Like, the first one?
Xenoblade 1, you can do in, like, 30 hours if you're just skipping fucking, like, everything besides the story. But you don't want to do that because it's got really legitimately good world building in its side quests.
Tifa's sad.
Xenoblade 1 is, like, a 70-hour game because it's so easy to get lost in its exploration. Just for fun, you know?
Mm-hmm. I remember, like, finishing that, and, like, I had 110 hours logged or something for the first time. This is the end for all of you. My god, Sephiroth, you just killed those trash bags!
Oh my god. One of the things that, drives me insane about Xenoblade 1 is that you will get to, like, the endgame state, and it's so easy to not, to, like, get, fucking, like, deer in the headlights at, oh my god, I can just go to the end of the game right now. But there's, like, another 25% of the game just in side quests in just the last chapter of the game. And a lot of it is really good side quests, too. Especially, basically, any quest involving, fucking Alchemoth post the incident.
The incident.
There are, like, parts of the, like, endgame content that wrap up plot threads that people complain that you don't see wrapped up in Xenoblade. You know that fucking bitch that, tried to assassinate Millia and then just dropped off the face of
yeah,
the planet after that boss fight?
Yeah, she's got a whole side quest.
She's got literally an entire side quest chain at the end of the game.
Oh shit.
To figure out what the fuck her deal is. Oh fuck, the Genova.
The Genova.
And this side quest is so funny, because there isn't a lot of side content you need to do for Featured Connected to make any sense. That's one of the things you need to do for Featured Connected to make any sense. Because she just shows up in that particular part of the game, and you have to go, wait, why the fuck are we just with you now? What happened? Did I miss something? You missed an entire side quest chain where she redeemed herself a little bit. Not like a lot, but enough to make her a bit more morally ambiguous than, oh, she just tried to kill one of the main characters. I'm sure Xenoblade 2 also has this issue, but the side quests in Xenoblade 2 are actually really bad. Not on, like, a narrative structure, but just, like, the way you initiate them and the way you go about doing them is so obtuse for no fucking reason. When one's side quests were so, like, oh, okay, we just grab the quest and go, let's do it, y'all!
You know, we were talking about I think it was, like, a couple days ago or something, like, I asked the question offhand, have you ever, like, received a game for Christmas that you didn't like?
Oh, you were talking about that.
I thought that was on stream.
Xenoblade 2.
Yeah, Except mine wasn't a Christmas gift, mine was a birthday gift, and I can't even, like, refund it is the thing, and I feel so bad about that.
No.
I genuinely tried to like that game.
I feel so bad, because Xenoblade 2 is very much like a game I think you can enjoy if you're willing to look past the flaws, but only the first time you play it. There is no subsequent playthrough that makes the game more enjoyable, because then you have to go through all the bullshit.
It's a game that gets worse every time you replay it.
I'd like to replay 3, actually. I think 3 ended up pretty fucking good. I don't think it was 1 good, but it's... 3 is... 3 is the sequel I wanted 2 to be, you know?
Yeah, like, I don't know. My thing about Xenoblade is I really, really, really fucking loved 1. Like, down to say, it is probably one of my favorite games of all time. But, like, there's something about it that makes me say only, like, the original releases of the game. Like, on the Wii and 3D.
And the 3DS one? Yeah.
Yeah. Like, I don't know. I feel like something was lost a little bit when... they
remade
it.
There's an ambiance to it that definitely is not present in the Switch version.
Like, but I don't know, just something about, like, the charm of it all. The art style, the character, like, I don't know. If that makes any sort of sense.
I think it lost a little bit in aesthetic, but what it lost in aesthetic, it gained in, like... quality of life shit in Definitive Edition actually legitimately makes me forgive the changes to the art style. Even just giving the game a fucking auto run button.
I'll respect that. Like, if you could have. I don't know. I feel like if you could have the aesthetics of the original release and the quality of life changes of the Switch release, like, yeah, that's like a perfect game right there.
I still think it was really funny that, once you get towards the endgame, you realize that they added a whole new level of, gem.
They did?
Oh wait, no, they didn't add a new level gem. They added, like, a whole new level for each skill. And, some of them are fucking batshit, actually. In a game that's so easy to, like, just do the, oh, I can just make a broken build with these three characters and stun lock every enemy in the game to death as long as it can be toppled.
Funny. Oh, Yuffie, come on. Yuffie, sweep. Oh no.
Oh wait, no, I'm sorry. It wasn't one, it was 2 new levels for each art. Goodness gracious. And that did include the Monado arts also.
Over.
This is so sad. So, Ginge, you know how Monado armor is objectively the best art in the game?
Yeah.
So at Matt's level in regular Xenoblade, it caps out at just a raw 75% damage reduction.
Oh.
In Definitive, it caps out at 85%. You are taking no fucking damage for like 10 seconds.
Holy shit. Okay. Okay, we're gonna do this a bit differently. Yuffie was a bad choice because she's kind of useless right now. Gonna slap some new materia on Tifa.
Within the comical realm of reality, where Monado armor, in Definitive Edition specifically, can give you better damage reduction than Tank LB3 in Final Fantasy XIV. More consistently as well. Which
oh
is freaky and horrible.
Oh my god, that reminded me. Ghosty, I need to.
Hang
on.
You need to send me a post? Is it perhaps
it's not a post, but.
perhaps about swallowing more current content? When are they dropping 6.55? Because I want to finish my Mandiful weapons already.
Fair.
I need to see what the last level of the Mandevilla Scythe looks like. I need it. Well, yeah, it's gonna be after New Year's.
Oh, this image I need to show you like right fucking now, Ginge. This
better
is a Christmas party.
Better be funny.
It is.
Oh my god.
And it's like, you specifically have to use a metallic PLA filament in order to get that look. If you use anything else, it will not look right. Wait, Ghosty, have you seen Die Hard?
Yeah, I've seen Die Hard.
Oh, okay.
Have you seen my favorite Christmas movie?
Yeah, I've seen Home Alone.
Oh, hell yeah, Home Alone.
Death! Death! Oh, it's because they did fucking holy damage, that's right! Let's go!
I do not know what yours is, though, Joes.
It's a live-action Grinch movie.
Oh,
you know
yeah,
what? I feel like that's valid, and I think people should stop being mean to that movie.
I love that movie so much. It's so good.
Is it the one with Jim Carrey in it?
Yeah.
Oh, hell yeah.
Have any of us seen Jingle All the Way?
That's the one with Arnold Schwarzenegger, right?
That is the one with Arnold Schwarzenegger
I have
in it.
I don't think
seen
I have.
Bits and pieces of it. I need to, like, watch the entirety.
We watched it in the living room for Christmas because it's a... It is not what I would describe as a good movie, but it's a really, really funny movie. Which makes it better, you know?
Okay, well, consider. Any movie with Arnold Schwarzenegger is good. That's just how it is.
I'm ready for three.
Okay, almost any movie.
I need to emphasize this movie featuring Arnold Schwarzenegger has him playing a completely normal dad. It's just him trying his hardest to play a normal dude.
Okay, let me catch myself here. Any movie with Arnold Schwarzenegger and he's not being an action hero.
True.
Because Kindergarten Cop is honestly one of my fucking favorite movies I've ever seen. And like, yeah, he's like an action hero-ish, but like a majority of it is him being a fucking kindergarten teacher. It's fucking funny. It is like movies where he has to step out of the action hero role and just be a normal dude are so fucking funny.
And he's like basically built for action.
Like, yeah, like the guy's built. Like, he is.
Well, he is also just
swole.
Built, yeah.
And, you know, he, you know, naturally lends himself really well to the action genre. So, seeing him play such iconic roles, such as, like, what he played in, like, Commando? He wasn't in Predator, was he?
I don't think he was.
Okay, well, he was the Terminator, of course, you know.
Let me check, actually. Because my nerd cred is at stake.
Played a lot of action heroes, obviously, and then, you know, like, you see him in a movie where he just, like, has to be a guy.
He was indeed in Predator. My bad.
Oh, I got distracted. I'm gonna make that silly fry now.
Chili fry, more like silly fry.
Silly fry. And I get to use the air fryer? Man.
Clearly you own an air fryer.
Today's coming up toasty, you know?
Do you, or do you not, have to plug in the air fryer?
I do not. The air fryer was already plugged in. I just keep confusing it for the rice cooker.
Is it, like, a really simple magnetic rice cooker thing, or is it, like, one that sinks in you?
It's a simple magnetic or simple electric one, you know?
Hell yeah. To be honest, those ones are the better ones, in my opinion.
I did a really fun thing with them, where I don't even heat the rice immediately. I literally just always refrigerate it and make some rice later.
Hell yeah!
Because I get it! I understand it, you know? I know what it's about!
That's a disgrace!
Oh, that hit the Discord audio moment.
Excuse me.
Cool, but I don't know if that's a blood thing, but I'm blood thing anyways.
I remember there was this one kid in, like, high school who always said bless you after someone coughed.
Ren does that to me.
True.
Why?
Because it's funny. I thought just crossed my mind. Binge, you're moving up here in the, or,
in
know,
the hopefully soon.
In the relatively near future. I think that we should make margaritas with my new blender together.
Okay.
Oh. Are you going to be adding the salt on the rim too?
I don't know, maybe? Probably.
Good.
Oh.
And you should also have margarita pizza. Which notably is not made with margarita mix.
No, damn it! The margarita sauce. That's a whole different guy.
Yeah. I just think it's funny that they're pronounced so similar.
It's a whole different guy to make out. Learn how to make, you know, margarita pizza. One of my friends apparently has been on their pizza cooking arc, and they've apparently had a lot of success with it. But maybe I should press them for tips on pizza.
Dessert. Okay, we're cooking.
Oh, you're now cooking.
We're cooking gas.
Yeah, my mistake was bringing Yuffie, and Yuffie not really being spec'd into anything, so she kind of sucks.
This is so sad.
And I don't think she has any of her good weapons either.
Oh, but you're like really close to the point where you can't just get her best weapon.
Yeah.
Aren't you? Yeah.
She's not really good until the late game is the thing. Or like, not really cracked, I should say.
She's not cracked until the late game, but when you get to the late game, she's kind of insane.
Yeah.
That's so funny to me, because you know what that reminds me of?
Yeah.
No, you don't.
No, I got the yeah.
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 So, the last party member you get in Final Fantasy X is also that game's thief archetype. And she is also the most broken character in the game, but for a very different reason. Her limit break is just, I'm going to combine three items together and make whatever the fuck I want to use. And you can make some pretty bad shit insane combinations.
Reflect ring. Genova cells. So that's what this is about. The Genova reunion. It's like a high school reunion, but fucked up.
Reunion? What, like...
It's not been Sephiroth we're after? I'll explain later. Right now, the only thing I'm thinking is about beating Sephiroth. But Sephiroth is... He's here. The real Sephiroth is just beyond here. And he's standing up. Received key item, black materia. The black materia is back in our hands. And all we have to do is defeat Sephiroth, and that'll be the end of it. We better not take the black materia any further. Why don't you give it to someone else to hold on to?
Like Sephiroth.
I don't want anything to do with the black materia. Me and black materia just don't mix. I said it's a little racist. How about if you hold on to the black materia? I don't think I can. Give the black materia to Baron. Don't give it to anyone. I'm counting on you.
You know what? I think this game does do it right, because this is the one game where I didn't have to ask, why don't they just give the MacGuffin to someone else so Sephiroth doesn't fucking mind game you again? And then that question gets answered immediately afterwards.
Let's find Sephiroth. We're going in first. You guys keep watch. Receive MP Turbo.
I also think about maybe one of my... Fire Emblem is a very funny and bad series. And there are a lot of things that it will never be forgiven for. The one I'm going to forgive it for is There's a really fucking funny cutscene in Three Houses where do we care about spoilers for a Fire Emblem game in Modern Era?
That is up to the chat's discretion. I personally don't, but I don't know if anyone else here does.
I don't care.
Okay. So there's a cutscene like about a third of the way into the game where you get hit with the token. Oh wait, you have a parental figure that's alive in a Fire Emblem game? No, the fuck you don't.
Oh no.
And then you as the main character realize, wait, I'm literally given a plot MacGuffin that allows me to reverse time. Why don't I just go and make sure he doesn't get killed? And you do this, and then another guy just pops up from behind you basically and is like, yeah, that's not gonna work, buddy. And stops you from stopping your dad's murder.
Oh my god!
Funny?
And it doesn't cross your mind to do that a second time, even though...
So you could stop the guy from stopping you?
Exactly. You don't get that far in the logic process. You just give up after the first attempt.
My god.
And everyone in the game is like, oh, this is so sad. This death could have been so preventable. And you're like, and I'm sitting here as the friend like, yeah. It could have been, couldn't it? Maybe if we used a couple more charges of that thing that we have, that you have to acknowledge in canon that you have right now.
What happened? Calm down, Tifa. Sephiroth is near. Anything could happen.
Sephiroth.
Oh my god, it's that town where nothing bad ever happens. Nibelheim. I don't want to go to Nibelheim. I want to go to Gungaga. I wonder who that is.
I keep thinking about how this game has like an unironic Shinji chair moment. And we're not there yet, but...
Oh, we're getting there. This is so stupid. Who was that?
I don't know.
This is terrible. Did Sephiroth do this? It's probably not me who will come out of the Shinra Mansion. He's gonna try and show us some of the stupid illusion. Who the fuck is that guy? I've never seen this dude in my entire life.
I hope they make a game about him. I'd like to know more about his character. He seems chill.
I don't know, he kind of looks like the guy who'd have a crisis in his core.
He looks like he fucking hates Loveless.
That I wasn't in Nibelheim 5 years ago. That's it, isn't it? I see you finally understand. What you're trying to say is that you want to confuse me, right? But even making me see those things won't affect me. I remember it all. The heat of the fire, the pain in my body, and in my heart. Oh, is that so? You were just a puppet. You have no heart. You cannot feel any pain. How can there be any meaning in the memory of such a being? What I have shown you is reality. What you remember, that is an illusion.
Shrug.
Shrug.
Chat?
Do you understand? I don't want to understand.
I don't mean to alarm you, but this is like almost word for word a cutscene from Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memory.
I want to take you back to your real self. The one who gave me the black materia that day. Who would have ever thought that a failed experiment would prove so useful? Hojo would die if he knew. Hojo! What does he have to do with me? 5 years ago, you were constructed by Hojo piece by piece right after Nibelheim was burnt. A puppet made up of vibrant Genova cells, her knowledge, and the power of the Mako. An incomplete Sephiroth clone, not even given a number. That is your reality. Shrug. What's wrong, Tifa? I'm not affected by it. I wasn't paying attention to him. Shall I show everyone here what's in your heart? You don't look well. What about this guy? Oh, he's dead. He's, got no texture
nope.
on the
oh,
bottom of his shoe.
He also blinked. He's not dead.
No, he's okay. He's just CP. He's just CP.
Just taking a load off.
I'll just shape the fire later. I'm just gonna lay here for a minute.
My original model wasn't meant to show you this angle.
He's gaslighting. He's gatekeeping. Do we think Sephiroth has titted up enough to say he's girl bossing?
Absolutely. I don't know why that's even a question.
I've seen some fan art where someone just straight up drew with tits, and I was like, yeah, this rules.
One of my good friends has drawn plenty of Sephiroth art, and every single time they draw him titted the fuck up.
Good.
I think I know which friend that is, too.
You would know exactly who that friend is.
Yeah.
You remember the photograph, right?
My tits were
the
huge.
The one at the embarrassing one at the Christmas party.
Oh, no.
The one where the fruitcake fell on your head, Tifa.
And it broke in half.
Tifa, you went to the Christmas party?
Cloud, don't look at the Christmas party photo! I should be in the Christmas party photo. I was there! Who the fuck is that guy?
Who the fuck is he?
Who's this dude?
Who's this dude? Why is Cloud's hair black now?
Oh, I thought
this picture's
like,
a
with
fake.
Black hair, like somebody turned their hair blonde as they grow older.
I saw my mom. I saw the people in town. Yeah, I went to Tifa's room. There, I played the piano. I looked in the drawers. I was normal about it.
I'm sorry, Ginge. I have a really funny post I need to put in Test Relay.
Okay.
But it's Sephiroth, Cloud, and Barret.
Oh my god.
I love character Quiznos the Destroyer.
Quiznos the Destroyer.
I command you to have hot sex with Patrick. You can't even control minds. What the fuck is wrong with you? Oh.
It's our good friend Rufus Shinra from the Shinra Corporation, who didn't do anything bad ever.
He's sitting there like, all I did was a little capitalism. It was one fucking time. And you won't persecute me for it.
I'm not responsible for the crimes my father committed. Sure, he dropped an entire plate on the city, but I didn't do that.
I think he'd be the type to say, I'm not responsible for all the crimes my father committed. I am, however, responsible for all the ones I did.
I think that's the most unintentionally raw and funny line I've ever heard come out of your mouth, Coasty.
Really?
I think you should use that. Oh no!
Weapon!
It's the Fortnite event! It means he's coming to Fortnite, everybody!
What's the plan in danger?
I think it's fucked up that the Final Fantasy VII Battle Royale died, and instead of collaborating with, you know, the most reasonable Battle Royale, to put Final Fantasy shit in, they said, hey Apex, you wanna dress Crypto up like Cloud for no reason?
I know, right?
Apex never does collabs is the funniest thing. It's like, that's the funniest part of that too. Like, okay, what is going on at Square right now? They're like, okay, we're gonna make the seven remake release Epic Store exclusive for an entire goddamn year.
But not collaborate with Fortnite.
You know, we have a good relationship with Epic. You know, Seven uses the Unreal Engine. You know, that's well and good. We're gonna stay Epic Store exclusive for a year. All right, sure. What's the next logical step to promote Final Fantasy VII? Collaborate with fucking EA and Apex. That makes a whole lot of fucking sense. I'm just saying. I think an LTM for Fortnite and Final Fantasy would be fucking funny. I want to find materia on the battlefield, and I want to summon fucking Bahamut on some 6-year-old and then hit the gritty on him.
True.
They are missing out. Oh my god, everybody fell asleep at the slumber party.
I'm hosting a slumber party at the Northern Crater Cloud.
You should really come. We're having pizza and playing Smash Brothers.
We're getting Little Caesars. You got your pick of cheese or pepperoni pizza.
No! I hate Little Caesars! It's $5 for a reason, Sephiroth!
But Cloud.
Don't you want the crazy bread?
But Cloud. It's hot,
hot
and ready.
And ready.
He says that like Nibelheim flashes behind him.
like you're going to be when we start playing some like
No. I wet Josie with a rolled up newspaper. No. Bad.
With a normie clock, that came out wrong. Do you want to get Papa John's instead? This is awkward now.
Oh my god. That was perfect.
Rufus is there also, Cloud? We like Rufus, don't we?
Everyone,
give me
thanks for everything, and I'm sorry.
Cloud, if you give me the black materia, I'll let you have an extra slice.
Sorry. Especially you, Tifa, I'm really sorry. You've been so good to me, I don't know what to say. But that extra slice is calling my name. That crazy bread. It's to die for.
Bro.
Please give me a number, Professor Hojo.
Shut up!
I think this is a mildly out of character moment because there's no way Rufus doesn't immediately shoot Cloud.
I think Rufus is, like, kind of permanently, like, underdeveloped as a character in this game. Because he's supposed to be, like, a secondary antagonist, right? Bro only has one boss fight.
And then he blows up.
And then he blows up in a cutscene that has nothing to do with your actions. Which I really hope in the later games of the 7 Remake Trilogy, they actually do that thing where they develop his character. There's no way they didn't give him a cool-ass design, and they're not gonna develop his character.
Bro, they gave him an action figure. He has to be important.
Okay, well, they also gave Lunafreya an action figure from fucking 15, and the only thing she does is show up in a few cutscenes and die.
Damn.
I don't mean to be mean about that, but that's literally what she does, and she's, like, the catalyst for the story happening. Of like, hey Noctis, go marry your girlfriend so we can end war. And he's like, okay. And then they go to get married, and summon Leviathan, and she dies. She doesn't even die in the main game, is the thing. She dies like in a line of dialogue, and then you have to buy a DLC to see how she died.
Oh my god.
Oh,
15 is so fucking funny, dude. They released that game in early access and didn't tell anybody.
God, 15 is so fucked up.
There's a series of videos that I really like called, like, Final Fantasy 15 in a nutshell, and, like, every time one of the DLCs is supposed to happen, like, the character comes back and is like, wow, what happened to you while you were gone? And they're like, oh, would you like to buy this DLC to find out what happened? And they just, like, keep moving and don't acknowledge it.
God.
And then they have videos for all the DLCs. It's so fucking funny. So really, for real, Sephiroth is out of his little cocoon now. But so are the weapons.
Uh-oh.
Now we gotta do a 16-player raid, everybody.
Time for a trial. Kick ass, actually. Looks like a Digimon, I love it.
These things are so fucked up.
Look out, they've got an AT field!
Tifa, no!
She's got physics!
Did her boobs go concave for a second?
No. No, they jiggled. Somebody in Square, 1990 something, had to animate Tifa's boobs jiggling like that by hand. They were on something. Oh, here come the fucked up noises. Oh, it's the Shinji chair. But it's the Shinji squat this time. If I was a small child playing this game, this would give me nightmares.
Fucking Hedgehog's Dilemma starts playing.
What's that one go like again?
I'm posting it in Test Relay. It's not the track I was singing, but it's also a relevant one. I love the Hedgehog Dilemma. I actually think that's a very it's a very fun and beautiful dilemma on, you know. Oh, the social contract, I suppose.
Vulnerability.
Vulnerability, yeah. Because it's been literally like 2 to 3 years since we watched Evangelion together, Ginge.
Mm-hmm.
The Hedgehog's Dilemma is the concept that the closer two hedgehogs get together, the more likely they are to poke each other. Yeah.
I remember. I absorbed media during that time.
You absorbed media. Proud of you.
I don't think I could recite all the themes without having to go into existential thought about it. Off the top of my head. But I did absorb Evangelion beyond a wow, cool robot standpoint.
True. Now tell me how the plot of Stormblood went.
So they had to go fight a war, but said we were too weak to fight the war. So we have to go fight another war so we can get these guys to help us fight our war. And they helped the guys in Doma fight their war, and they won the war. And then they went back and they won their war. And now everybody's happy.
Hey, now tell me what happened in the patches.
Yotsuyu.
Yotsuyu. Yotsuyu. Sobbing.
Sorry, women.
Women didn't deserve that.
I keep meaning to bother you about
the
more
shadow
final
leader.
My more final.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, it's been 7 years. You joined Soldier, but you quit after the Sephiroth incident, and now you're a mercenary. You told me a lot about what happened after you left Nibelheim, but something was wrong. I felt there was something strange about the things you talked about. All the things you didn't know that you should, and other things that you shouldn't know that you did. I wanted to make sure, but then I heard you were going far away. And I didn't want that. I didn't know what to do, so I thought I needed more time. And that's why I told you about the avalanche job. I wanted to be there with and watch you.
Can I make a hot take for you?
What's up?
And this will make sense the further you get into Shadowbringers. I regret to inform you that Aster is the alpha in the whole game.
The smart-ass kid who nobody likes.
Yeah, and then he gets cracked and goated, actually.
But also horribly traumatized.
A little bit, yeah.
Mm.
No, he has to get horribly traumatized to get goated and cracked.
Yeah.
When the do-do-do-do-do-do starts playing.
I fucking love 14, because Alphino's such a funny guy. He goes from a bratty little teenager who made it to college way too early to, like, still a teenager, but now he's contemplating the horrors of war that he's witnessed.
Yeah.
And how to be a better person. And I'm like, man, that sucks, dude.
I love my son.
Like, anyways, dude should be worried about a driver's license, not this shit.
Dude, yeah. He should not be solving the war. He should be at the club.
He should be getting his first job.
Alpha, no, you're fucking 18. Can't you go buy a scratch-off ticket like a normal kid? No, he's not 18. He's still, like, 16, isn't he?
There's actually some, like, crackhead theories because, they've deliberately not shown Alphino in the, trailers for the new expansion.
Mm-hmm.
And some of the crackpot theories are that he will show up in the last, trailer before the expansion, and he will have, physically aged a little bit.
I kind of hope that's the case, because I would like to see my dear son growing strong and healthy.
Because in case you didn't know, Alphino's an Elizan, by the way, which means he's one of those tall-ass elf motherfuckers. They just have really intense growth spurts, like in canon.
He's gonna be fucking tall the next time we see him.
Lanky motherfucker.
What if they just take his model and just stretch out his limbs so he looks all weird in his figure?
Dude's gonna walk into Dontrail looking like fucking Estinian 2.
Judd just grins at him, claps his shoulder, and just like, wow, you're almost as tall as me now!
Do you just like seeing characters grow up? Is that what I'm interpreting?
It's cute.
Yeah, I like seeing characters go through development and growing, both physically and mentally. Also, goddamn, that's the meteor.
The meteor, baby! That's the Fortnite event! Oh, we're playing as Tifa now. There's no Cloud in our party.
Oh no!
Sorry, you get a new main character now.
The boy!
We broke the last
boy
one.
White boy gone.
This is such a funny part of the game. Sorry, we need a new main guy. You broke the last one.
I thought Cloud would show up to save you all. Professor Hojo wanted to check up on Cloud too.
What are you gonna do to Cloud?
Sephiroth's alter ego. Meteor has been summoned. Essentially, it's all but over now. So there's no need for you now. No, there may be an important task for you.
President, preparations for the public execution are complete! Execution? What are you gonna get by executing us?
You are to be executed for causing the situation. People are ignorant. They'll feel better as long as someone is punished.
Fucking Hellstar Ramina shit.
I take back what little praise I have for this damn jackass. Well, enjoy your last moments together.
Oh, that was Rufus saying that.
I'll tie your arms now.
Thanks, Heidegger. Very cool. can't wait.
And now we get to play as Barrett.
I can't wait for the new caster job to be Green Mage. It's gonna be Green Mage, right, chat? Right, chat? It's gonna be Green Mage? It can't not be Green Mage. It could. They're throwing out some very heavy hints that it's gonna be Green Mage.
Alright. Alright, chat. We're running on two and a half hours now. This is the first save point we've had since the incident.
You've had since the incident.
I think this is a pretty good part to cap off on, because we're gonna have some excitement to go through next stream.
In the new year.
In our next stream, new year, it's gonna be 2024 next time I stream. I'm not gonna stream till next year, guys.
We're not gonna stream until next year.
Yeah, it's crazy. Anyway, I'll see you all next year. Ghosty, do you have anything you want to show?
No.
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 Damn.
Sorry, I'm not funny enough.
Does anybody have anything they want to shill?
I don't have a schedule. I just kind of stream, like, sporadically. But, I'm streaming again.
Watch out for Al's streams. I'll be sure to if you stream in an hour when I'm awake.
Yeah. That's it.
I've seen you streaming a couple times, and I'm like,
Yeah.
I think I either was busy that day, or I forgot.
That's okay. There's no obligation.
Yeah, but I like watching my friends do funny things. And you're my friend, and you do funny things.
That is so true.
Oh, the rats.
The rats!
The rat appears.
Mwah, 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 mwah. Oh, that's the wrong song. Anyway, we're gonna play more Final Fantasy VII and witness the public execution of Avalanche next stream. Yippee!
Oh,
I'll see you guys in the next one. We're not streaming, but we're still in the VOD. Does anybody have anything funny they want to add?
I think they should legalize old men.
Legalize summon materia.
Legalize summon materia, true.
What happens if you smoke the summon materia? Don't answer that.
I can't say that on stream.
Don't answer that.